Hello people, in this video we want to look at dactylography. Basically you can say study of fingerprints. Study of fingerprints is called as dactylography. Okay, so what are we looking at? Study of fingerprints, dactylography. So basically, after taking the impression of the papillary ridges of the fingertip, so you take, this is fingertip. Take the finger, in the tip of the finger you have the fingertip. On that, if you see, you have papillary ridges. The impression of these papillary ridges is nothing but fingerprint. So you're going to study that. That is dactylography. You will use it for the identification of person. It is also known as fingerprint system, dactyloscopy, dermatoglyphics, or Henry Galton system of identification. So if they ask you dermatoglyphics or dactyloscopy or fingerprint system or Henry Galton system of identification, it's all the same thing. Now let's go to the principle. Principle. Fingers of each individual have a pattern formed by the ridges. These fingerprint patterns are distinctive. Even in identical twins, they don't have the same pattern. Why? Why even identical twins have different fingerprint patterns? Because, see, identical twins also will have same have different fingerprints. Though they are identical genetically, they have different fingerprints because the fingerprints are formed because of the pressure of the amniotic fluid on the hand. So, because of the pressure of the amniotic fluid on the fingers, the fingerprints are formed. So, that is why the fingerprints are different even in identical twins, even though they are genetically absolutely the same composition, right? Now, there are three types of patterns here. You have the loop pattern, whorl pattern, and the arch pattern. Loop is something like this. Loop pattern. Then you have the whorl pattern. And then you have the arch pattern. And then you have the composite pattern, which will have all the patterns combined. Okay. And these fingerprints, they don't change. They are permanent. Life through life, they are same. They don't change, but they can change because of some disease or something, but otherwise they don't change. Okay. Now, loop pattern is most common, 65%. So you can explain how it happens. There is ulnar loop, there's radial loop. So if it is towards ulnar side, if it's towards radial side, so it's called as an ulnar loop or a radial loop. So you have two types of loop here. What and all you have here? Ulnar loop, radial loop. Two types of loops are there. Then whorl pattern you have, then you have arch. Arch can be a plain arch or a tented arch. What is a plain arch? Wave-like means it will be plain. If they are sharp like spikes, then it will be tented. Sharp spikes, if they are there, they'll be tented. Something like that. Okay. Then fingerprints, let us look at some other points here. So basically, the next thing they're talking about here is the recording of fingerprints. So you can use stains like printer's ink on white paper, unglazed white paper, normal white paper. On that you can take finger to record the fingerprints. For routine purposes, they use the left thumb. Okay, left thumb usually is used. For legal records, they are saying all the 10 fingers, they will take the fingerprints. Computerized fingerprint readers are there nowadays. They take for 8 digits. Okay. At crime scene, let us see at crime scene how the fingerprints are going to be used. At crime scene. Now, crime scene. So, basically, you have three types of patterns here in crime. There also you have some types. So, let's look at this. There is visible print or patent print. Then you have the plastic print. Then you have the invisible print, that is latent print. Okay, so what are the prints they are saying? You have visible, invisible, and middle they have put some plastic. Visible means they are patent, like you can see them. They are made because of blood or dirt or oil or something. You can actually clearly see them. You don't have to again develop them. Visible is visible, right? Then coming to plastic. Plastic means you have the impression on some soft surface, like on butter, on soap, on cheese. That's an impression. And latent means invisible. You can't see it. You'll have to develop it. Like these are, you need some additional processing to develop the print. Then only it becomes visible. This is called as latent print. Okay. Then lastly, they're talking about identification. Guys, remember that when they ask types of fingerprints, you have to write this type also, whirl, loop, whirl and arch. Then you have to write this also, visible, plastic, invisible. Then coming to identification, final identification is made by comparing numerous characteristics of these. So the ridge areas, the sequence, the ridge endings, bifurcations, lake formation, island formation. So there are some formation here. You have to check all that. Lake formation, island formation. Then, so you have to, there are so many, 20 points are there. At least 8 points should match. At least 8 out of these 20 points, 16 to 20 they are saying, out of 16 to 20 points, at least 8 should match, okay, for identification. Alteration of fingerprints. Why do you think fingerprints get altered? Because of leprosy, because of electrical injuries, because of radiation, because of eczema, acanthosis, nigricans, scleroderma, atrophic skin, rickets, acromegaly. All these can change the fingerprints. Now let us look at mutilation of fingerprints. Basically, why would somebody try to change their fingerprints? They mutilate it, they change it, they want to erase their fingerprints because they have probably committed some crime and they want to hide their fingerprints. So they will self-inflicted wounds. They can have burns, they can apply some corrosives, they can rub their hand against a hard surface and erode it, skin grafting, electric injury, exposure to radiation. So this is mutilation of fingerprints, okay? So now let us come to the medico-legal importance of fingerprints. We already told you identification, right? Identification. So dactylography is the best method for identification. It is superior to DNA fingerprinting, they are saying. God, why? Because it's easy, cheap, simple, fast. It can be collected from the scene of crime. And that is the thing, you know, DNA, anybody can plant it. They can just put something, your hair or something, and they can implicate you. Fingerprints also nowadays, they're trying all that, but they're saying that you can easily pick it up from the scene of crime, right? It does not require any sample from the accused. So accused may refuse to give sample, but here government is maintaining all Aadhaar records and all. We have the fingerprints, so no need to ask for the accused to give any sample like blood or saliva or semen or etc. Then, fingerprints of even identical twins are different. So that is a very nice thing. That is called as QT-LET rule. QT-LET rule is nothing but identical twins will have different fingerprints. This is QT-LET rule. Then, it is absolute identification. There's no chance of error, they are saying. Okay, so this is about dactylography. We are done with the fingerprint study. Bye-bye.